Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. During the time when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was born in Mecca, it was tradition amongst the rich and important people to give their newborns to babysitters who would raise and take care of the children for a few years outside the city where the air was fresh and clean. They raised them like their own children and gave them milk, and in return they got paid. At the time when Prophet Muhammad was born, a group of women from the tribe of Bani Sa'd came to Mecca to accept newborn babies to raise and feed them. Halima Sa'diya was amongst these women. But because she and her husband were poor, their camel was old and weak, and the other women went ahead of her. Prophet Muhammad's father, Abdullah, had passed away, and he was cared by his mother, Amina, and grandfather, Abdul Muttalib. When the babysitters found out that Prophet Muhammad had no father, they saw that they probably were poor and wouldn't pay them enough. So they all decided not to take him and went to choose the kids with rich fathers. Because Halima arrived late, the only child left was Prophet Muhammad. When she too discovered that Prophet Muhammad didn't have a father, she didn't want to take him, but then she thought to herself, "Because every other babysitter has an infant, I must take one too." So she went to Prophet Muhammad's mother, Amina, and accepted to take him. She stayed in Mecca that day. The infant was always hungry, but that night she had enough milk to feed both her kid and Prophet Muhammad. The next morning, her husband told her, "I think this child will give us blessings." From the first second that Prophet Muhammad became part of Halima's family, they were showered with Allah's blessings. Halima said that the camel that was so old and weak when coming to Mecca during the way back went faster than all the other camels, in such a way that people asked Halima, "Is that the same camel which you came to Mecca with?" When the Prophet entered the tribe of Bani Sa'd, he made Halima's life blessed. Halima's sheep gained weight every day and gave more milk than usual, in a way that even though milk couldn't be found anywhere in the tribe of Bani Sa'd, Halima's sheep gave more milk every day. Halima's life because of Prophet Muhammad became a lot better. Before the coming of Prophet Muhammad, Halima's family had been the poorest in the tribe of Bani Sa'd, but afterwards they became the richest. Prophet Muhammad was with Halima for 5 years until she returned him to his mother Amina and his grandfather Abdul Muttalib. Salawat.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.